So, it's the following day. I've got a fancy new spear that's been upgraded to actually do more damage than my other spear, but I haven't tested it yet, so it may suck. Oh, right. I appreciate you don't have to, like, confirm that anymore. You can just do it. Ow. My pizza is attacking me. So I've got two summons, half a pizza, a new spear. Let's fucking go. Three summons, I guess. I'm not sure how useful this spear is gonna be. I do know that I need to fucking hit him first, though. I haven't figured out if he's on a timer for the second one or if it's damage based. I would have thought damage based, since it always appears to show up at half health. Alright, let's go. This is not going nearly as well as it did the last few times. I'm doing more damage, but we're not really fucking helping. I have no idea how you're supposed to solo this fight. It seems ridiculous. Like, one of these seems ridiculous. I would have to be doing like 3 or 4 times the damage I am now to even have a chance at beating this thing normally. Yeah. I'll just fast forward to when I beat them, so I don't have to talk so much, and so I can eat my food. Congratulations, Elden Ring, you have finally come up with- Why does it get its health back when that happens? Anyway, you've come up with a gargoyle fight that's worse than Maneaters. Congratulations. The one in DS2 where you have to fight 6 of them simultaneously is easier than this. Holy shit. That's one. Fuck off. Oh my god, that elevation difference sucks. If he's standing at even a slight difference in elevation, it will fucking ignore your shield. I feel like I'm fighting Ornstein. Oh my fucking god, that took way too damn long. Holy shit. Fucking Christ. It's a twin blade, I don't care. And the great sword is a regular great sword, not an ultra great sword. It looks like it's covered in sulfur. Oh, and it does sword beam. Okay, fine. If I can create some kind of build that can carry multiples of those at the same time, maybe I'll consider that. I mean, what kind of build would that even be? Wow, that's actually not... If I built towards it, I could maybe do that. I don't think I'm gonna fucking do that, though, because that'd be stupid. But it's a possibility, I suppose. Fucking hell, though. What? Wait. Oh. Oh, weird. I'm still overweight. Huh. Weird. Is there anything else in this room? I get a grace. I didn't even get enough souls off that to level up. What the fuck? Fuck. I want to put something else on here. What would be good? Blessing to sleep. Oh, that's pretty good, actually. What do I need for this? 38. Yeah, hold on. And blessing. Yeah, I think that'll work. Is there anything at all over here? There's a coffin. I hope this doesn't change my fucking appearance. That was actually something that kind of pissed me off about DS2, is that it would change your appearance and there was no way for you to change it back. And going through the coffin didn't actually change you back to your default appearance. It fucking, just gave you a similar one. Well, fuck it, I might as well check it out. Oh, a cutscene even. Okay, I'm curious. We've had this in every game since Dark Souls 1. And actually, I don't think there was a Nessalon coffin in Dark Souls 3. There were two in Dark Souls 2, because there was the... Okay, it's a transportation one, I think. It's not a... change my gender coffin. Because we're not playing as Hollow anymore, we're playing as Silt. Hollow has faded into the nothingness of the Souls universe, never to be seen again unless I find another reason to play Dark Souls 3. Huh. Well, that's interesting. And not at all where I expected to end up. Jeez, you can't even see my face. Where the fuck am I? Oh, this place looks pleasant. Is this Ash Lake? Deep Root Depths. Okay. Oh, the coffin's... No, the coffin's fucked. I suppose I should have expected that. Oh well. And since she did such a great job, I'll keep her on here for a little bit. Oh, am I gonna fight another boss now? Well... Oh. Great. Fucking... Well, actually, Oleg can help me out with this. Or not. Fuck me. Oh, it's just a normal enemy now. It's not even a boss. Great. Question, does this one also do Scarlet Rot? At least if I die over here. Jeez, I can barely block that. I was wondering when it was gonna do that. Oh, they don't track as hard with this one. Like, not nearly as hard. You know, I would feel a little better about this if that wasn't the same fucking moveset as the goddamn, Hade Knights from fucking... Dark Souls 2, the old Ashen Ones. Or not the old Ashen Ones, but the old Ancient Knights. You know, the ones that used to have unlimited stamina that would attack you forever. Yeah, it appears that as long as I'm moving in a fucking half circle pattern, it can't actually hit me with the fucking... I almost fell off the fucking edge. Just hurry up and die. Motherfucker. That's a dirty trick. That is such a fucking dirty trick. I can't lock on to fucking efficiently dodge the projectiles if it dies. I wonder if it's programmed to always do that as its final move right before it dies. That wouldn't surprise me in the slightest, if that were the case. I'm just gonna do a cursory once over of this, because I'm going to assume I probably cut out most of my attempts fighting the fucking gargoyles. If I didn't, something is clearly wrong. God. What is this? Why do I feel like I'm playing Borderlands? I'm not supposed to be here. I'm gonna leave. The real question is, does that guy respawn? Because I never want to fight him again. Ever. If he respawns, then this whole area needs to be postponed. No, it looks like that was a one-time enemy. That's good. I wasn't looking forward to fighting him again anyway. That's a white one, too. That means he has an item. Shit. Maybe I can just shoot lasers at him or something. This area looks like it sucks. Well, I guess it was the quote-unquote reward for me defeating those gargoyles, so I would imagine, yeah, it probably is designed to suck.